Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to my channel. My name is Gavin Fish. I'm very grateful to have you here. Today has been a crazy day on my channel. I think it was just a couple of videos ago, I said that a little channel like mine, I can respond to all the comments and I do my best to respond to the comments. And then today around noon my time, I posted a video and decided to take kind of a before lunch nap. I took a 20 minute nap. And when I got up, there were thousands and thousands of views on the video. So this is a completely new experience for me. I'm actually a little bit nervous, and hopefully I don't totally ruin things today. But the purpose of this video, this live stream, is to talk to you guys about the timeline. I made a couple of major errors in my last video. I can't believe I didn't catch them, though I have been trying to do kind of more live style videos rather than super prepared and produced style videos. So I guess I shouldn't be surprised that I missed it. I said that that Gabby was probably dead on the 26th, when we know that she was seen at about 1 o'clock on the 27th at the Mexican Grill, Mary Piglet's, I think was the name of that grill. And which tangentially is probably the best name I've ever heard for a restaurant. But anyway, I made several mistakes. I got corrected on them. I have not been able to really respond to very many comments because everything changed so much on the channel today. I think there were more comments that were like hidden, right? That YouTube holds back for me to approve than I normally get on any of my videos. So I haven't been able to go through and respond. I don't know that I will be able to do that, but I'll do my best. Victor, thank you very much. I will say that while I am really honored to have my channel break through like this, I'm nervous that I won't be able to keep up with the content. I'm hopeful that I'm able to do that, but I appreciate what you're saying. Red Zeppelin, honor and respect, my friend. Thank you very much. Right back at you. I really appreciate it. Lisa, let's see right here. Thank you for this. We'll be back with pencil sharpened. Thank you, Lisa. Really appreciate it. And let's see. One other comment from Red. Greetings from Seneca County, Silver Creek Village, along the wooded shoreline of the Grand Erie Lake, deep in the wild, mild west of New York State, of wine. You know, Red, I have traveled many a highway along Lake Erie between where I live in western Pennsylvania, and I've gone up into the Fredonia-Dunkirk area along the lake, and then up in up along Lake Ontario when you get up to like I'm blanking on the name of those little towns, but you know, up northeast of Buffalo, beautiful area. So thank you for joining me. Okay, the reason that let's just go ahead and get into it. I think I'm nervous here, and that's why I'm kind of rambling. Okay, we're gonna continue on with the case of Gabby Petito today. One of the things that I try to do in all of my investigations is seek good documentation. Documents or witness statements or those kinds of things that I can count on in order to make my conclusions or I guess make my hypotheses and try to test those conclusions. I try really hard not to just guess or not to just kind of speculate on things, though I was called out on lots of speculation on my last video. So I'm not saying that I don't do that. I'm just saying that I try really hard to not do that. And so I look for documentation. So Desiree, hello, Gavin, and everyone new sub. Thank you very much. Thank you for being here, Desiree, and thank you for subscribing. Holy cow. Guys, I started my day today with 7,400 subscribers and change, 7,425, something like that. And right now we're over 10,000. So thank you for all the new people who have subscribed. Thank you for all of you who are watching these videos. Guys, it's amazing. Miss Heather Elise. Hi, Gavin. Hello, Heather. Thank you for joining it. Okay. I want to take you over to my website here for a second. These are the cases that I'm working on. I had kind of resisted making a Gabby Petito case page because I didn't feel like I am really, I still don't. I don't feel like I'm the expert on this case. It's obvious that I'm not. It's a case that I'm very interested in for a lot of different reasons, probably mostly having to do with the fact that I have children about her age. And when I look at her, I'm reminded of my own children. So I resisted doing a case page, but I put one together today, hoping that we might be able to build on it together. So let me just show you what I'm mostly interested in doing. As with all of my case pages, I put in all the documents that I can find and make it possible for you to be able to see them. Now, I have a plugin on my website that makes it much harder for people to download. There are other cases like the Amanda Winkowski and the Shelby Thornburg case where their family has asked that I do that, that I make it so people cannot download those documents. Because, you know, in some cases they sued the police or the county in order to get those documents. They don't want them just out. So that plugin is making it difficult for these case documents to be able to be downloaded by you guys. I will figure out a way to fix that. In the meantime, I've made them viewable. But here is where I really want to focus, and that is building a reliable, well-sourced, well-documented timeline of events surrounding this case. And I think that we probably want to start with about the time that Gabby and Brian left on their trip. And we'll try to keep it updated throughout, you know, as things happen. What I'm doing is I'm making sure that I put a source to anything, any bit of information, so that everybody can go and actually see it. Now, I've only added a few things to it, including the Mary Piglets event that I completely hosed up on my last video and, you know, didn't mention. I actually said that I thought that she was dead by the 26th, but, yeah. So I'm hoping that if we do this in kind of a methodic, maybe crowdsourced way, we would have a better chance of getting really good, accurate information. And so in order to do that, I wasn't able to figure out how to make a plugin where you guys could just submit and there would just be like a process for me to check it and then authorize it. So instead, I've set up a Google form where you can go to the Google form and you can just give me basic information. Man, my internet is slow. It must be because I'm live streaming. Basically, just kind of tell me the title of the event, like I've done up here. The description of the event, which is kind of this down here, and it can be long or short, whatever amount of detail that you think is good, please put that in there. And then put the date and the approximate time, and then provide a source. And if you guys will do that, and I will continue to work on this as well, we can build a good timeline and a list of good sources. So, yeah, that's pretty much what I wanted to show you. Now, I've got a couple questions coming in here, guys. Let me just go through these here real quick. Came across your channel today. You have a fresh outlook and style. Congratulations on the success. Sandra, thank you very much for that. I really appreciate it. Jamsy, Gavin, thank you for doing this. Jamsy, you're welcome. This is going to help me as much as it helps anybody else. I'm very interested in the case, but everything is so dynamic. And one of the things that I complained about in my last live stream, I may have even complained about in my last video, is that the news cycle is so fast on this, probably faster than actual news comes out, that even in my alerts, I continue to get alerted to brand new news articles that don't really say anything new. They're just kind of hashing through the same news. And it's really difficult to, you know, kind of, I guess, wade through that and blow off the chaff, you know. You know, it's like, it's really hard. So I'm hoping that that we'll be able to do this. Let's see, Rob. Hi, Gavin, also from PA. All right, thanks, Rob. I wonder what Gabby's last day was, but seems like the 28th. They were reportedly spotted in Idaho at an Opera House restaurant later the night of the 27th, leaving around 10 p.m. So I haven't seen that. The last, I guess, witness statement that I've seen from the 27th was that one from Red, White, and Bethune, where they saw the van around 6:30. So Rob, if you can find that report, please upload it to this form so we can get that on the timeline. That would be extremely helpful. I would love to be able to do that. Thank you. Cynthia Anderson. Hi, Gavin from New York. Hi, Cynthia. Thank you. Okay, let's see. I'm going to go through here. J.S. Warner 319, they were seen at Mary Piglet's 1 to 2 p.m. on the 27th. That was the last sighting of Gabby, to my knowledge. That's the last sighting, to my knowledge, as well. Guys, thank you so much for all these compliments in here. I really, really appreciate it. Let's see. Does anyone know the time of day the text, "Can you help Stan," was sent on the 27th? Let's see. The only documentation that I can think of that we have on that is, let's see, I think it might be in the search warrant, right? Let's see if we can get that open for a second. Let's see if it has any details on that. Let's see. Okay, that here we need to get to the affidavit. Grounds for issuance, probable cause. Let's see. 27th, 2021, the subject's mother received an odd text from the subject. The message read, "Can you help Stan?" You know, it doesn't say anything more than that. JS Warner 319. So I personally don't have any knowledge of that. But if, again, if anybody does, head over to that form and give us your source so that we can figure that out. I'm very interested in that. Miss Heather Elise, wow, this is awesome. Thank you. I'm glad you like it. Nobody says August 25th, the Monarch, Ogden, Utah. So Ogden, Utah is, if my geography is correct, Ogden, Utah is north on I-15 from Salt Lake City. So if that was a sighting, is that what you're saying, Nobody? If that was a sighting, I would love to have that submitted over to the form that we're working on. Another thing that you guys might be able to do, if you ever want to upload documents or anything like that, if you go to my contact form, and actually several people have availed themselves of this today, where they were correcting me on a couple of issues, and this is how they reached out to me. And I was really glad that they did that because I was so lost in all the commentary. I kind of feel like I'm running the risk of if I put this out there, then my inbox will be flooded too. But I would rather err on that side than not know something. So in this form, you can actually upload a file. So I didn't want to do that on the Google form because it gave people access to my drive. But if you do have any documentation, Please, in the comment section, just tell me where that documentation is from. Give me a little bit of information and then send me those documents. I would very much appreciate that. And we can build this out. Okay. Let's see. There is something from Gavin, please discuss, from somebody named The Goodness, but I haven't gotten what it is that they want to discuss. Rob Danner, let's see what your previous thing was. I don't see what you were previously said, but you said here, people have been mentioning it a lot on Reddit. I'll have to go back and find their sources. You might be talking about the Monarch in Ogden, Utah. Yeah, so if you can find those sources, man, that would be terrific. I hate to move on tangents here, because the case that we're discussing here is Gabby Petito. But I want to give you an example of why good documentation matters. And I'm going to do this by talking about the case of Amanda Winkowski, which is a case that several of you have gone back to look at on the channel. Amanda Winkowski's death was ruled an accident when it was suspected by her family to be a homicide. And when I reached out to her mom back in October, almost a year ago, she explained to me why she thought that Erie County got it wrong. And then Erie County, this is New York, dug in their heels. They just wouldn't move. Well, Leslie, who is Amanda's mom, shared with me and my partner, Rick, over 1,800 pages of investigation files, files from the Buffalo police, files from other police agencies, the New York State Police, other localities around Buffalo, files from the Erie County Medical Examiner's Office. She provided to Rick and me a little bit more than 400 images of the crime scene, of the first autopsy, of the second autopsy, just tons of stuff. And as we dug through those things, we were able to prove that, at least to our satisfaction, that there's no way that this was an accident. They ruled it an accidental overdose. And in their own toxicology report, on a very small line, there was a metabolite of heroin, which was Amanda's drug of choice, that came back as negative. And I talked with a pathologist who said there are very few silver bullets in pathology, and 6-MAM, which is that metabolite, is one of them. So that got us to the point where we could actually sue Erie County and the medical examiner's office, claiming that they're acting arbitrarily and capriciously, that they're not looking at the evidence. And that case is pending before a judge right now. So I love documentation. I love to be able to dig in on this stuff. In this case, in the case of Gabby Petito, I think it's going to be hard to find very much documentation, but there are leaks that come out. That search warrant that we just looked at, that was leaked out. That is a sealed document. And while I don't want to endanger the case that they're building, I do want to help. So anyway, that's why documentation is so important to me. Let me go back and check a couple things. See if there are a couple things. Patricia Burns. Have you heard about the book that Brian was using like a life manual? It's very disturbing. So Patricia, I have not heard of that. I don't know anything about that, but I would love to know more. Let us know. Let's see, Jen, that case was riveting and tragic. Thanks for telling her story. I think you're talking about the Amanda Winkowski thing. Yeah, that is guys. It is a disturbing case, not only in the way that she was killed, and I guess by whom she was killed, but the way that the system victimized her a second time, and everybody in that system was comfortable doing it. It's absolutely crazy. Jamsey says, I checked out the website. Great job so far. Thank you. Thank you, Jamsy. Let's see. The real Cynthia. Hey, not to be confused with any of the imitation Cynthias. This is the real Cynthia. Dog got tip. Parents took Brian to campsite. Okay, so this is one of those guys. I think Cynthia is talking about Dog the Bounty Hunter. This is one of those cases that is bringing people out of the woodwork. And I was talking with my friend and frequent collaborator, Rick Tracewell, on this earlier today. Dog the Bounty Hunter is somebody when it was years ago, I was actually working as a limousine driver and it was like the night shift. And so at the limo company, I usually had hours to just kind of sit on my duff between rides. And on A&E, Dog the Bounty Hunter was on. And so back then I was a real fan and really felt like he was a guy that would give people second chances, right? He would pursue them, he would capture them, but then he would put his arm around them and tell them it'd be okay. And I really respected that. My thought today on Dog the Bounty Hunter going and knocking on the door is it just seemed like a real publicity stunt. But if he did get a tip that parents took Brian to a campsite, I would be interested in that. Patricia, the book is Lullaby by Chuck Palahniuk. Man, I don't mean any disrespect by mispronouncing that. But thank you. Thank you for letting us know that. So if you would, guys, let me just see if any of you are watching right now and you have any ideas, any documented, things that we can add to the timeline, please go ahead and hop up there and do that. I'm just going to check to make sure that, yeah, we've got three responses so far. Guys, we've got three responses so far in the, yeah. Excellent. Guys, including links to your sources. Guys, thank you very much for doing that. I will hop on that. I'll verify the sources and I will add them to the I'll add them to the timeline. And I think that we're well on our way to building out a very, very good timeline. Let's see if it does say there are a couple new comments. Let's see, Sherry Parr, let's see what he says. He heard, hears sleep disturbances. Dr. Grand confirm criminal psychologist. She says, hears voices. So Sherry, if you can find that source for me, I'd really appreciate it. Thank you. And Lisa, good job, guys. Yeah, I echo what Lisa is saying. I love that we can get together as a community and really do this. I guess, you know, there's no point in belaboring this unless you guys have any other questions. I don't need to sit here and just wax rhapsodic about, you know, what I'm interested in the case or why I'm interested in the case or the things about the case that interest me. I think we can just go ahead and wrap it up. If you please have sources, please do send in those responses and I will continue to update the timeline. And yeah, let's see, one last question. Oh, we got a fourth response. Thank you guys. Does anyone have any documentation for Brian traveling home for a few days around 8:17? I was called out on this today when I covered it in the video that I did earlier. They said one of the comments, several of the comments that as I was scrolling through said that has been widely debunked. So if it has, I apologize that I spread that out again to the masses, especially on a video where I think the back end is now saying 140,000 people have watched that. Guys, this is absolutely nuts. 142,000 views on that video. So if that has been widely debunked, I'm sorry that I put it there. But if there is a source, and by the way, somebody did email me Mike Schmidt's contact information. I'm hemming and hawing on whether or not I should reach out to him, but that is the uncle who allegedly wrote that. that timeline. So I don't know. I don't know if Brian Laundrie did go back to the to Florida the way that pitcher said. Let's see, a couple other things. Let's see, JS Warner 319. Did he not decide to use the credit card until the 29th? She could have been dead for a few days before he decided to use it. Peter writes, credit card fraud was for August 30th to September 1. That is correct in the indictment. Let me show this to you guys real quick. In the indictment, where is that? I'm probably looking right at it. Missing person, title, press release, indictment. Here we go. In the indictment, it does say from August 30th through and including on or about September 1st, you know, the card was used. A card ending in 8774 was used. So, yeah, I mean, here I am going into the speculation side of things again, but did he run out of money? You know, who knows? You know, Donald, his speculation is kind of like mine. I think he started to use a credit card to purchase fuel on the way back from Florida. And J.S. Warner says that credit card usage from August 30 to September 1 coincides with the time in which he would have been on the road. Yeah, I have a couple of experiences driving from, in my case, Pennsylvania to California. It takes a couple days, guys. If you are driving hard, from where I am, it's 40 and a half hours. If you only stop to very quickly to go to the bathroom and fuel up, it's 40 and a half hours. So yeah, Florida to Wyoming, Idaho, Utah, that whole area. Yeah, it probably was just those couple of days. Let's see, going back over here, Carolina, the voices that is important. Any record of him having psychiatric evaluations before Gabby in his life? If there are, I would love that documentation. You guys know what to do. Thank you. Let's see. Miss Heather Elise says the lullaby book was actually being read by Gabby. It's in a photo. Brian was reading a different book, but they could have also swapped books. Thanks for saying that. If you've got links to those photos, I'd appreciate that. Oh, Sherry, yeah, Dr. Grant is on YouTube. He's done a few videos on them. Actually, I have seen a couple of those. Yeah, yeah, I think he's very brave to sit there and talk about those sorts of things as a as somebody who has those bona fides. I think he's brave to do that. I think it would be helpful to verify timeline events through Gabby's relatives. So, Lisa, you're not wrong. You're absolutely not wrong there. And I have experience in reaching out to relatives who have lost loved ones, though in my experience, it's been years later. So I kind of feel like while you never get over something like that, time has kind of tempered things, not made it quite so raw. As I'm not a trained journalist, I just don't know what the ethics there are on that, if I should reach out or not. I do have the contact of her uncle now, but anyway, I think I might need a little bit of encouragement to do that. Sherry, he used her credit card in Illinois. If there is a if there's a video of him fueling up anywhere that anybody knows, I would love a link to that. Or any receipts that have leaked out. I would love links to that. Thank you very much. Okay, Patricia, this one is something that I have read. I've read people on Facebook saying this, that, he went back to Florida. He could move Gabby's belongings into a storage unit. It was Gabby's mom who said this. I would love a link to that because I've only read people who have said that. I haven't actually seen Gabby's mom say that. So I'm not calling you out. I'm not saying it didn't happen. I'm just saying I don't have the documentation. So if you find it, upload it, will you, to that form. Let me see if you guys are busy on that form, by the way. Let's see. Yeah, six responses now, guys. 6 responses. Good job. Carolina. I don't quite know how to pronounce that. I think in English it'd be Carolina. But as I spent much of my youth speaking Spanish, anyway, he didn't flee for no reason. She says, no one flees and hides if they didn't do anything wrong, unless they're on drugs and they don't want anybody to see them using. This case has me. I can't really find this records. Yeah. I hear you, right? It's like, and people will react to, like, if you look at the history of crime, you know, some people try to hide in plain sight. People like Scott Peterson, for example. People, well, he didn't do this successfully. It lasted a very short time, but Chris Watts. Or, you know, Paul Flores in the Kristen Smart case. They tried to hide in plain sight. Others, yeah, they go on the run, right? And, yeah, it gets, I'm kind of with you. Though I think it is plausible, or it is at least possible, that somebody would go on the run out of fear that people would think he's guilty. I think that's a possibility. But yeah, I've kind of leaned towards what you're saying. The goodness, could you drive to Florida from Wyoming on one tank of gas? There surely must be footage of him gassing up somewhere. Do you think FBI would be doing this? So I haven't checked the actual mileage. My cars, and I have a van. It's a minivan, so it's not the same thing. On the freeway, its range is about, you know, 400 miles, something like that. So no, I don't think that you could drive from Wyoming to Florida on one tank of gas. I think he would have to, he'd have to fuel up. Could his parents privately admit him to a psychiatric facility? Well, I think that's possible, though I think it's very dangerous to lie to authorities, right? They've said publicly through their lawyer that they don't know where he is. And I mean, I'm not law enforcement here. I'm not a lawyer, but I do know that lying to a federal investigator is a crime that you can be convicted of. So is it possible that they told the feds one thing and publicly told the rest of us something else? That is also possible, I guess. But then I go back to what my friend Rick over at Solve Crimes TV says, you know, let's weigh what's possible and what's probable. Yeah, the possibility is there, but what are the probabilities? I'm not sure. Victor, that's when his dad bought Uber Eats, correct? Do you guys have documentation on the Uber Eats thing? If you do, I would like to know that. Bucks, hello from Oregon. Bucks, hello from Pennsylvania. Thank you very much for joining. Can the lawyers find doctor's records if he has any? So this goes back to a process which is, it's a probable cause process. In order for them to get medical records, they very likely will need a search warrant to do that. That means that they will have to prove to a judge that they have probable cause to do that, which means that they will have to fill out an affidavit very similar to this one right here, right? An affidavit where they tell the judge, these are the grounds under which I believe you should issue this search warrant, and here is the probable cause, and they list it out, right? So the question being, can they find the doctor's records? Yeah, if they can convince a judge that they have probable cause to do that. Let's see. Patricia, I find it odd that Brian's parents have not gone to stay elsewhere while all the media are at their home. Maybe it's because Brian is in his mommy's attic. And then she says, Victor, you're correct. And that's the Uber Eats thing, which I would love documentation on. Okay, so I have not published this interview, but recently, like in the last month and a half, I sat in the office of a chief of police, asking him about another case, and asking him about how they searched in this case. And he talked about the technology that they have in order to find, in that case, they were looking for a deceased body, or and they had aerial vehicles. In their case, it was a helicopter that had this technology where they could, it was infrared technology that they were using, right? And he was telling me that just barely minute changes in temperatures could be detected from hundreds of feet in the air. And so I would imagine that if Brian Laundry is in his parents' home, the FBI would probably know about that. And if anybody is on scene or has been on scene down there, I would love to know if there have been helicopters in the sky or drones in the sky. I would imagine, let's see, I'm a certificated drone operator. I'm trying to think of the aviation regulations on that. I would almost certainly say that no private drones would be flying over the Laundry's house right now. Okay. Sherry says, do you give out email? No, Sherry, the best way to contact me is on my website through my contact form. Let's see. His Instagram account was active for 3 seconds, showed water and a piece of green boat. So is that on his stories, or is it deleted, I guess, is what I'm wondering. And if it is, did anybody screen capture that? If so, I would love to see that. I'd love to see the source on that. Who said that? Me, Chick. I would love to see the source on that. So if you have it, please go to, there's a link in the description of this video. You can submit it there. It looks like we have 9 responses so far on the timeline, guys. Good job. Thank you very much. Let's see, let's go down. Rose, dog found their campsite. So has that been reported on, or has that been testified of by Dog the Bounty Hunter, or, you know, what are our sources on that, Rose? That's my big question. And where was the campsite? So go ahead and, yeah, stick that in to the timeline form. That the link is in the description below. Let's see. He stopped in Illinois. Tyler Feller reported he used an ATM there. I would love that source. Let's see if that's been put in there. Doesn't look like that anybody has put that in the responses. So I would love that source. Give that to me. I'll add it to the timeline. Patricia, I will send you the link also to Brian's secret Twitter account. Please do, Patricia. Thank you very much. Let's see, another interesting new item, tip uncovered by Dog, is the Laundry camping trip was to Fort DeSoto. Is that the, so I know that there were neighbors who said that Brian Laundry and his parents were preparing like a camper that fits in the bed of his dad's truck to go on a camping trip. Is that the camping trip you're talking about, the Fort DeSoto? Let's see, I'll keep going. Let's see, she was last seen alive on the 27th, and he is hitchhiking on the 29th. What do we know about the 28th? That is a good question, Peter. I actually haven't seen anything about the 28th yet, so if anybody knows, please let us know. Her dad mentions Uber Eats in the Dr. Phil interview. Okay, so I will look that up. If you can help me, I shouldn't be so lazy, Melissa, but if you can help me by giving me a link to that, I would really appreciate it. That would help me out a lot. Here, this is a good question. Timeline, I'm Brian Laundrie. Do we know what date the family lawyered up? I personally do not know the answer to that question, J.S. Warner, but would like to know. Jamsey, you said the same thing. Dr. Phil interviewed the father. That's where he tells Phil about buying her pizza while she was at a hotel. Okay, so I will look that up. Thank you. Let's see. Keep going. Lisa. I'd like to see activity on Gabby's social media during the time of Brian Laundrie flying to Florida. If none, wondering if he took her phone, keys, credit cards with him as a form of control. You know, a lot of people have talked about that. In fact, one of the videos that I was kind of called out on by some people, I did it for the purpose of debunking what was happening, but Janine Pirro said that she talked about the signs of domestic abuse, domestic violence, that control being one of the things that abusers use on their victims. So yeah, that would be great. And if anybody who's watching this has, you know, any knowledge of that, that would be great. What about a relative's home? I think if he was outside, he would have been seen by now. I have faith that investigators are searching all the homes. I doubt that they will let us know that. The boat thing on his Instagram was debunked. See, I don't know either way, guys. I believe what you're saying, but I don't know either way. So if you have you know, documentation or links for me to look at, I'd really appreciate it. Let's see. Barbara Duchesne is saying September 1st. I think you're probably responding to the question about, do we know when, they lawyered up? It stands to reason. I mean, the van did arrive in town on September 1st. So I would imagine that it was about that time. But if anybody has documentation on that, I would love to see it. Let's do a plug. Catch a Pocket podcast, Lori Burress, or Burress. I hope I pronounce your name correctly in one of those attempts there, Lori. He's dead. No way. He's dead. No way. He hasn't killed himself. I mean, a lot of people believe that, and a lot of people actually are hoping for that. I said that in my last live stream. I can't personally hope for that. But I don't think it's outside the realm of possibility. I don't ever want to, I don't ever want to wish that somebody would do that to themselves, because it just leaves so much destruction in its wake. Suicide is a terrible, terrible, thing. All right, guys, we've been going here for about coming up on 45 minutes. So I think we will probably leave it at that. I really appreciate you guys tuning in. I really appreciate you guys subscribing and participating with your comments and your likes. I've been working on a YouTube channel for 13 months now. I started in, I think it's longer than that. I started in August of last year with my friend Rick Tracewell on Solve Crimes with Rick and Gavin. In May, I decided to go off on my own, and Rick has continued, and now he's called it Solve Crimes TV. It's a great channel. You should check it out. But I've been at this now since August. So yeah, 13 months. My math skills aren't the best there. And have never really had a video that has gone into the many thousands. I've had videos that have gone into the couple thousands. And most of my videos get a couple hundred views. But today was just an incredible day in that we got 142,000 views on that video. So many comments. I think the last time I looked at it was like 1400 comments, so many likes. And then we reached that, that first goal of 10,000 subscribers on YouTube. That has been extremely long time coming, and I'm very grateful, guys. I express my deepest gratitude for you guys coming and checking me out. I think you will find, as you watch my videos, I'm going to make plenty of mistakes. I'm going to be wrong a lot. I'm going to say things like, I don't want to, to guess, and then I will guess. I'm going to be imperfect about these things, but I think I've decided that from now on, I'm going to do fewer long-term, take weeks to edit and shoot type of stories. I'm still going to do them because I love them, but I'm going to try to do more kind of live-ish kind of stuff. And because I love interacting with you guys, and I think it's a good way to do it. The video that I did today that got so much response, I shot it, did a couple little edit tweaks, and uploaded it in less than an hour. And I was picked up by the YouTube algorithm, and a lot of people saw it, and a lot of people called me out on where I got things wrong. And I actually appreciate that. I'm not blowing smoke. I really appreciate that. So I kind of like the ability to go back and forth with folks. And I appreciate it. Okay, Robo Kathy. Let's see, two more comments before I wrap this up, guys. Robo Kathy says, confirmed on camera that Brian and his parents checked into Fort DeSoto Campground September 1 through 3, then again September 6 through 8. On the 8th, only the parents left. Info shared with the FBI. Robo Kathy, that is a great handle, by the way. If you can get me a link to that, just like help me out, since you already know that information, if you can help me out and put that into the form that's linked below this video, I would really appreciate it. And then the last one, Martin Moore is saying, when will you share your timeline? The timeline is currently published, Martin. It's on my website, gavinfish.com. Just go to the case page. You'll see the Gabby Petito case is right here. And as you go to the page, you'll be able to see the case documents. And again, I said this at the beginning of the live stream. Right now, you're not able to download these documents because I use the same plugin that I used with other cases where I've been asked by the families not to allow that. I will figure out a way to make these downloadable so you guys can get them and share them. But the timeline is down here. So far, I've only got a few things up there. But as I get more stuff, I will add to it. You can submit your entries right here. It just opens a Google form. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 questions. And then, as I said before, I'm just going to say it one more time. If you hit contact me on my website, that is where you can upload files. If you have any PDFs or JPEGs that you want me to take a look at, that is where you can do that. So, with that, guys, I believe I will, I've had so many false endings over the last 5 minutes, but I think that is a good place to call it a night. Thank you very much for tuning in. I bid you adieu, and I hope to see you on the next video. Take care. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you liked what you saw, please subscribe to my channel. And if you have any comments or questions, please leave them below.